Hello dear students, the topic which we are going to study today is poison apparatus and biting mechanism in snakes. Snakes are long, cylindrical, limbless and ectothermic or the cold-blooded animals belonging to the class Reptilia. There are around 3500 species of the snakes worldwide, and out of which approximately 350 species they are poisonous. And in our country, around 69 species of the snakes, they are found to be poisonous. Here is a table which shows some of the common poisonous snakes of India, which include the cobras, grates, vipers and the sea snakes. And now comes the first part of our today's topic, which is the poison apparatus of the snakes. In the buccal cavity of all poisonous snakes, a poison apparatus is present, which consists of a pair of poison glands, a pair of poison ducts and a pair of fangs. So first are the poison glands, which are modified labial or the parotid glands, present one on either side of the upper jaw. These poison glands, they are kept in definite position by special ligaments. This diagram, it shows the poison apparatus of a snake. Here we can see these are the poison glands present at the roof of the buccal cavity. These poison glands, they are surrounded by fan-shaped muscles, which are termed as the constrictor muscles. These constrictor muscles, they play a very important role during the injection of the poison into the prey's body during the snake bite. From the interior end of each poison gland arises a very narrow duct, which is termed as the poison duct. This poison duct, it opens at the base of the fangs. So this poison duct is the second part of the poison apparatus, and the third part are the fangs. These fangs, they are long, curved and sharp maxillary teeth, which means the teeth present on the maxilla bone. Each fang, it has a poison canal or a poison groove which extend from its base to the tip. Depending on the position of the poison canal or the poison groove, these fangs, they are typically of three types. So the first type of fangs, they are termed as the solenoglyphers. The solenoglyphers fangs, these are hollow type of fangs, which means that they have a poison canal present in its center. Here is this diagram showing the longitudinal section and the transverse section of a solenoglyphers. So in the center of the fang, we can see here this poison canal. Apart from this, these solenoglyphers fangs, which are present in vipers and the rattlesnakes, these fangs, they are foldable, which means that the fangs, solenoglyphers fangs, they remain folded near the roof of the buccal cavity when the mouth of the snake is closed or during the resting position. Then the second and third type of fangs, which are termed as the proteroglyphers and the opisthoglyphers fangs. These protero and opisthoglyphers fangs, instead of having a poison canal, they have poison grooves on their surface. In proteroglyphers fangs, the poison groove is present along the anterior surface, and in opisthoglyphers, the poison groove is present along the posterior surface of the fang. So here is this diagram of a proteroglyphers or the opisthoglyphers fang. These proteroglyphers fangs, which are present in cobras, grates and the sea snakes, these fangs, unlike the solenoglyphers, they are not foldable, which means they remain permanently erect even during the time when the mouth of the snake is closed, or during the resting position, these fangs, they remain erect. So next are the opisthoglyphers fangs, in which the poison groove is present along the posterior surface. These fangs, they are present in the colubrid snakes. So these three are the parts of the poison apparatus of a snake. And then next part comes the biting mechanism. Next part of our topic is the biting mechanism of the snake, in which we will study how the snake it bites. So in biting mechanism, very important role is played by the jaws and the muscles of the snakes. The skull and the jaw bones of the poisonous snakes, they are highly flexible and they are movably articulated, which means that when one bone it moves, it pushes the adjacent bone, pushes its next or the adjacent bone. So here is this diagram which shows the position of the skull and the jaw bones of a viper snake. when its mouth is closed or during the resting condition. In viper snake, as we just did, that the fangs, they are foldable, and during the resting condition or during a in a closed mouth, these fangs, they remain folded near the roof of the buccal cavity. But in case of the cobras, the fangs, they are permanently erect. And now we'll do the mechanism of the snake biting in case of vipers, in which the fangs, they remain folded in a closed mouth. The biting mechanism in vipers is completed in two parts. The first part is the erection of the fangs, and this part, it involves a series of movements of bones and the muscles in a specific sequence. So this erection of the fangs, this will do with help of this diagram. So during the erection of the fangs, first of all, these digastric muscles, which are present at the posterior end of the skull, these digastric muscles, they contract, and due to contraction of these digastric muscles, the mandible or the lower jaw, it is lowered. As the mandible is lowered, it causes the opening of the mouth. The mouth, it opens, and as the mandible, it moves, it in turn pushes this next bone, which is quadrate. Then this quadrate bone is pushed forward, and then forward pushing of the quadrate bone is accompanied by the contraction of these next muscles, which are termed as the protractor muscles or the protractor pterygoid muscles, we also term them as. So simultaneous contraction of these protractor muscles and forward pushing of this quadrate bone, these two actions, they push this bone, which is the pterygoid bone, forward. Now this pterygoid bone is pushed forward, and as this pterygoid bone is pushed forward, it in turn pushes the next bone, which is the ectopterygoid, or we also term this bone as the transverse bone. This transverse bone or the ectopterygoid bone is now pushed forward, and as this transverse or the ectopterygoid bone, it is pushed forward, it in turn rotates this maxilla bone outward. This maxilla is the fang bearing bone, means these fangs, they are present on this maxilla bone, and as this maxilla bone is rotated outward, these fangs, they are now, they become vertically erect, and now with its open mouth and erect fangs, the snake is ready to strike. The snake, then, it can embed its fangs into the prey's body. So this is the opening of the mouth and erection of the fang, and the next part is the injection of the snake venom, which involves simultaneous contraction of the fan shaped constrictor muscles, which are present around the poison gland. So the contraction of these constrictor muscles, it causes the flow of the poison from the poison glands into the poison duct, and from the poison duct into the poison canal or the poison groove of the fangs. As the poison, it enters the fangs, then this poison is injected into the prey's body like a syringe. So after this, as the venom is injected into the prey's body, then the mouth is closed, and this closing of the mouth, it is caused due to contraction of these muscles, which are termed as the anterior temporalis muscle. And as these muscles, these temporalis muscles, they contract, this mandible or the lower jaw is raised and the mouth is closed. And it is accompanied by now the relaxation of these protractor and the digastric muscle. These two muscles, they relax now, due to which all these bones, these maxilla, ectopterygoid, pterygoid, quadrate, all these bones, they now come to their original position, and now this fang present on the maxilla bone, it is again folded back. So this is a whole biting mechanism of the snake, which involves a sequential movement of these bones and the muscles. And the last part is the snake poison or the snake venom, which is a clear viscid liquid produced by the poison glands of the poisonous snakes. And this venom, it is a complex mixture of various proteins. And on the basis of the action which this venom it causes on its prey, or the effect, how it affects its prey, the venom, it can be snake poison or the venom, it is broadly classified into two types. First is the neurotoxic venom, which acts on the nervous system, and second is the hemolytic venom, which causes the breakdown of the RBCs and the small blood vessels of the prey. Venom of crates, cobras and sea snakes is neurotoxic, and the venom of the vipers is hemolytic. So that is all for today's topic. I hope you understood it well. Thank you so much.